Hello everyone, and once again welcome back to my channel Server Gyan. My name is Dr. Lokendra Singh, and within this video we are going to continue all the questions which were remaining part of previous video. Okay, so like how to kill a process of any user. So let us create a user first. User add maybe Tom, and I want to run couple of commands, maybe vim slash temp abc. And this come, okay, let us run vi command. Okay, leave vi, let us run ping command. Ping www.google.com, and I am running this in background. Fine. So then after I want to control z. Sudo su hyphen logged in as root fg. I'm going to break this command. So ps fax grep ping. So ping command is running with this PID. I will kill it. Okay, ping command has been killed. So now I want to log into this particular user. su-tom. So I want to run any command, maybe top command I want to run with this user. And but if I run, I shall not be able to log out from here. Okay, not a problem. So let us open a file. What command can I run using this user? Okay, so I can run maybe, okay, let's run a ping command. Once again, ping google.com. fine, and now I'll log out from this user. Let's run in background and I will log out from this user now. Okay, so now I want to kill all the process running by Tom user. So if I run a command psf, okay, let me log into new terminal first, otherwise it will not be a fun. Down desktop, I'll have to go to my desktop, and here I'll paste the command to log into my server. Sudo su hyphen I'll run. Now I will make this font a bit larger for you guys. Yes, now. So if I check that what all users are logged in, so I can easily check that EC2 user is logged in 2 times, and this user is idle for last 41 seconds. Now, if I want to check psf ax grep tom, so no command is running. F, okay, let me grab the particular ping command. So the ping command is running, and owner of this command is Tom. I can check user with faxu. So obviously Tom is the particular user of this command. Now I want to kill all the process which are running by Tom user. So I can run a command pkill hyphen u Tom. So Tom ping command is gone now. It means ping command is not running. Earlier this particular output was coming, but right now there is nothing remaining. Fine. So this is how we can kill all the process of any single user. Okay. So now what is the next question here? Okay, ping command is stopped here. Ping command is stopped. Okay, so what is the next question here? Okay, how to mount disk permanently? Okay, so for checking disk, I have a command here, fdisk hyphen l. So, okay, fdisk hyphen l. Yes, so there is a particular disk which I can use, which I can format and mount it. So for formatting this, mkfs .ext4 maybe, or any file system I can use. After that I will mount it. So Now, if I want to check that disk has been formatted or not, so first of all, this this particular output will list down the information that file system has been created, that creating gender and rest of like writing super block and file system accounting information done. Everything has been done. So if I want to mount it, or if I want to check file system is created or not, ls blk command I can use. So it will show only those file system where only those disk where file system is created. Okay, so now what I'll do here is /etc and fstab. So there are two ways to mount it. So either you can mount it in permanent manner or in temporary manner. So what I'll do here is /dev/xvdb, then after /mnt is going to be my mount point, then after ext4, that is going to be my default file system, and attributes defaults I will keep it, and 00 will be my like file system checking option. Okay, now I will run a command mount hyphen a. If I run df -th, then that is this disk is mounted in permanent manner on /mnt. Now I will need not to, if I reboot my system, then my disk will not go away. But if I remove entries from that particular fstab file and I try to reboot my system, then this disk will go away. Okay, how to check hidden files and how to create it? Okay, so let us go to /temp and let us see if there is a particular hidden file. So ls-la option is used. So if you check here, there is a particular file dot, and there is a particular file dot dot. Fine. And there is one more file dot font-unix. There is a particular more file dot ize-unix, and there are multiple dot test and dot x11 and this one. So multiple files are there. So what does it mean? It means these files are hidden. How to create it? So you can run a command touch dot abc. So all the files which you create, so these files are not shown to you by default, but if you run la, a means all, it will show you hidden files. And the advantage of hidden files are like these are not visible to all, and you will have to specify hyphen a switch to print down all the files. Then after, how to start any process at a startup. So for example, you have two ways. Either you can write a script which will bring down your system, or you can make entries within etc rc dot local file system. You can make entries within this file and the services will come up. For example, you want to mention your service httpd restart or start, whatever command you want, that will get executed at the time of startup. Or if you do not want it, so what you can do here is additionally cron tab -e for edit. Now you will make entry here @reboot, then your command, whatever command you want to run, so it will run for you. So I have not mentioned proper syntax, so you can check it yourself. Okay, so how to run a process at a startup time. Okay, how does nameless, what does nameless directory represent? So if you go here, maybe within /etc or maybe /temp. Okay, so let us go to /etc. So if you check here, multiple directories are here, multiple files and folders are here. But if you run a command ls-la, so it will show you some extra data. So first of all, it is showing dot, and second one is showing dot dot. What does it mean? Both are directories, both are owned by user root. So dot means my current working directory, and dot dot means my parent directory. Okay. If I go to /nf ls-la command, so what does it mean? My current and my previous working directory. Fine. So this is how we work with current and previous working directory. Okay, so when we talk about okay, this question is already completed. How to check free disk on the file system? So command is df -th. We can check that what is total size, how much is used, and what is available size on the disk. This is how we can use. So df hyphen capital th command we can use. And if you want to check inodes, so df hyphen ik command you can use. So you can check how much total inode are available, how much is free and how much is used. Okay. Okay, next question is, okay, this is done. And how to check open ports on Linux server? Okay, interesting question. Netstat hyphen tunlp. So this will show that what particular port is open and what service is listening on it and what is PID of the server. Fine. This is how you can check all the remaining ports, and in fact it will tell you that what ports are listening on UDP and what ports are listening on TCP. Okay, how to check open ports on Linux server? This is done. How to check CPU usage for a single process? Okay, we will run top command and after that we will run here capital P we will press. So as we can check here, so this particular process may be HTTP or maybe systemd, maybe top. So how much resources does this particular command use? Fine. So like this is CPU utilization, this is memory utilization for systemd. In the same manner, you can check any service here and you will be able to figure it out. Like how much total CPU it is using and all. And top command I have already explained, so you can check that video as well. How do we deal with mounting file system or partition? So we have already checked. And like if you need to check it in more detail, so there is a particular file which is known as /etc/proc/mounts. You can check that file system as well. So it will list down the information in like such a weird manner. But if you want, find mnt is a particular command which you can check, like what all file systems are available, like what is source, what is file system type and what are the options available. So this particular prints the same information which are available within /proc/mounts. So if you check all the file system, all the information is available in both the with both the commands. Like find mnt is such a fantastic command which will print the information of /proc/mounts in formatting system, formatted manner. Okay, how to find use of a command which you do not know? For example, there is a command maybe twet. T is a command and I do not know the use of it. So how do I need to check? So the command is what is and twet. So read from standard input and write standard output to files. You can write output to multiple files, that is T. Okay, for example, you do not know you do not have information about telinit command. So just type in command what is and after that telinit. So it will print information. Change sysv run level information. Fine. So that is how you can check about a command which you do not already know. Okay, then after, how to check if ACL is set on a file? So the command is get fsl /temp.abc. Maybe fstab we can take. So there is no ACL implemented. If there is ACL implemented, then definitely this will print the information here. How to set fsl? So set fsl hyphen m means modify user tom, give permission rwx on file /fstab. Now if I check once again, then obviously it will print the information that user tom redirect permission, these are the particular options and these are the permission which are set on this particular, and obviously it is giving removing leading slash from file name. Fine. So this is how we can set and we can check as well. What command do you use to check attribute of a file? So attribute means the particular additional attributes which are available on a file. So lsattr command is used to check additional attributes of a file. So there is no attribute. How can I set? Chattr chatter and after that plus I to make it immutable and after that the file name. So if I check it once again, so it will say that I is already available here. It means now this file cannot be deleted. If I run a command rm -rf /etcfstab, then this particular operation will not be permitted now. If I remove it, so I can use chattr -i and after that file name. Okay. Then after, what would happen if I remove execute permission from a directory? Okay. So let's check that thing as well. So I'm going to create a directory, maybe slash data. I'm going to create data exists, so maybe slash lokendra. Now if I check the permission of a file, so the particular permissions of these files are ls-l. Let us check the permission of lokendra directory. So the permissions are rwx, rx, rx. Fine. So now if I user, if I logged in with user Tom and I try to run a command cd and this directory lokendra. So yes, Tom user is able to log in. Now what I'm going to do here is, if I remove permission ch mod o minus x, it means I'm removing permission from lokendra, execute permission for others. So if I run a command su then Tom, and if I try to log into lokendra once again, then it will say permission denied. Why it is so? Because cd command works with execution permission on the top of a directory. Okay, so if I run a command chmod a minus x, it means all, for all users, execution permission is denied on lokendra directory. If I run, if I want to do cd with root user, then it will be allowed. Reason being, because this is super user, because this has complete rights on everything. Okay, so I'm getting a message, no space left on device, and df-th shows 50 GB free. So the option here is the thing which I want to discuss. So it's always not necessary that disk space can get filled, but obviously there is a particular option df-ik. It means inodes can also create problem. If 100% inodes are used, then also your disk space can remain free, but your inodes can get full. So that can be a possible reason. Okay, then after, next question is how to check if OS is running on a virtual or a physical machine. Interesting question. So that is dmi decode. So that command, that particular print, that particular will print grep -ivm. So HVM, it means hardware assisted virtualization, it is running on. So this is a virtual machine. Otherwise, it would print DMID code, will print here, maybe it is of IBM, HP, or whatever type of hardware it is using. Okay, so this is how we can check. Okay, next question is how to change owner of a file. So you can change like chown is the command, chown tom, then after group name you can specify tom or whatever else group you want, then after maybe slash temp and any file. Okay, let's say .abc. So if I check the particular owner of this file, ls-la, now the owner is Tom and group is Tom. So whosoever is going to work with this, so you can change it. Maybe you can mark this group as sales or whatever. Okay, so what is use of nmap command? Very interesting question. So some interviewers usually ask that how can I check open ports on a remote server? So yes, we can check that. So how to use that nmap? Okay, command is not available, let's install it. Yum install nmap minus y, and obviously it will get installed. Okay, my mistake, I'm extremely sorry for that. Typing mistake. So yes, nmap is being installed. Now I can hit this command nmap -a a.a.8. So whatever IP address you want, you can check it out and it will print the information about a remote server. So whatever ports are open, so it can take some time for sure. Maybe 10 to 15 seconds, sometime it takes even a minute. Fine. But obviously this command will let you know that what all ports are open on that server, what all services are running on that server. So this command is used for that in the same manner. Last question is how to remove an inode from Linux file system. This question is for you guys. I would like to hear answers from your side about this question, like how to remove inode. I'm not talking about file. I am talking about physical location of a file on the server. For example, like if I run a command here, I cannot run a command here because it is gone. So the question remains same, that how to remove inode of a particular server, inode of a file. So how can you do that? You will have to tell me, and that's your task, that's your job today. So it will take some time, but obviously this command will print all the information. So keeping this video short, I want to close it right now. Otherwise, definitely it will take some time, maybe a minute or two, it will become lengthier. So you can try this out, this command, or maybe onto a local server or wherever. Okay, I have an idea. Why not I run this command onto my own server? Because obviously, okay, finally. So the output is here. We have the output now, and yes, I will explain it. So first of all, port number nmap scan this one, latency is this much, not shown port this many, open ports like port number 53 is open, TCP wrapped, port number 53 is running on TCP, port number 443 is running on TCP, and these are the fingerprints, 404 not found, and after that, this is like information about like this server is related to Google, public Google DNS. Then after valid before this, and like expire, this certificate will get expired this time. Then after like a warning, OS scan results may be unreliable because we could not find at least one open port and one closed port. Fine. So device is general purpose running OS, just guessing, open BSD 4.x. That is the operating system information. That's great. It means Google is also using Linux. Then after, no exact OS match for host, testing condition non-ideal. Then after, network host distance 14 hops, and like trace route ping UDP, this information is available. Total time taken 87.80 seconds. Fine. So this is how you can check open ports on a remote server. Great. So when I have copied my server as well, to let me hit this command for my IP address as well. So it will take some, once again, the same time, and you will get the results. Yes. So zero host, and like what all ports are open, you can check it out. Host seems to be down because I have not allowed this particular thing on my server. So, okay, this is it for this video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Have a good time. Happy learning from Server Gyan. Please do like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and keep on sharing with your friends to share knowledge and to make them grow. Happy to see you learning.